Lord God Almighty, worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb.
We celebrate the Lamb of God.
Worthy is the Lamb.
For you are holy.
You are holy.
You are holy. You are mighty. Holy. Celebrate you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Everybody clap your hands unto the Most High. Woo! God. Our God is good.
All the time.
Hosanna. Hosanna. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna.
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 Glory, glory,
glory,
glory, glory,
name. Praise Him.
Received a testimony, so we would like to hear the goodness of the Lord and what God is doing in our midst. Amen. This testimony is coming from our pastor from Kumasi, Pastor Harry Mingo.
Some of the musicians will also have their promotion and how much energy or effort I put in, but I see that she was blessed. I believe this will encourage somebody.
Please, can we start?
Not to give up in whatever he or she is doing, because the Lord is always looking up on us, right? And this thing all came about not because I'm so special. I believe this thing came about because I am under a great covering and a great unction of testimony with you. Pass carries to you, family, and I just want to share a testimony with you. The Lord has been so good for me. He has been so good for the family. He has been so good for the church. And it's not because we deserve it, but it's because it is He that shows us mercy. 2023 was one of those years that as a business we had a very tight situation. This was a difficult year for us, and things were not so good. But the Lord was so good to us, and at the end of the year, even though we didn't deserve anything, we didn't deserve to be in a position, the Lord showed His mercy to us, and I had a promotion last year, and it was crazy because that was so unexpected. Some of my team members had their promotion, and it was also so unexpected. But the Lord showed that it is not by how hard I work, it is not by how much energy or effort I put in, but it's He that shows mercy. I believe this will encourage somebody to not to give up in whatever he or she is doing, because the Lord is always looking up on us, right? And this thing all came about not because I'm so special. I believe this thing came about because I am under a great covering and a great unction of Reverend Paddy, and this is Kitchen. And if you are here, you are in the right place, because there's a great covering of grace that we have. I believe the thing that we have to do as church people, as believers, is for us to position ourselves properly and to be able to be partakers of those covering. And there are three things that I mostly do that I want to share with you that I believe will also go a long way to help you to be able to assess the grace that he has. One of the things that I do, firstly, is not to become familiar with the patterns that we have as a church, and the patterns of convocation, the patterns of whatever we do at every point in time, and then listen to the teachings of Daddy regularly. There's always a tendency for you to become familiar with the patterns and become familiar with the teachings. So I've heard this before all over again. What I do is to have my devotion, daily devotion every time by me, and go back to some of the readings, some of the teachings that Daddy has played over the years. And that sustained me in our difficult times when we as a business, we were going down, right? And it sustained me really well, because I went back to old teachings, I went back to old CDs, and I listened to those messages, and that inspired me greatly. The second thing I do is also try to lead the teams that comes out every year. Last year we said we are making strides, and when the banner came up, there was a gentleman who was trying to move forward. That mental picture of that gentleman trying to move forward stuck with me every time. And then at every point in time, wherever I find myself, I always have that mental picture in mind. So irrespective of the situation, irrespective of how difficult it is, there's always a picture that tells me that you need to move forward. You need to take a step forward. There has to be an improvement. There has to be an increase. There has to be an advancement. And that picture always stuck with me. Moving forward. So irrespective of the situation, I believe that's why God showed me that irrespective of the situation that you're going through, you need to move forward, and I have to move forward. And that's why the Lord showed me mercy and increase, and I have to move forward. And that's why the Lord showed me mercy and increase, and gave me that increase in terms of my promotion. The last thing I also do, and I believe I didn't do much of that last year, that's why I struggled, was to sow into Daddy's life. And I tell you, at every point in time that I've sown into Daddy's life, there has been a multiplication. It's one of the things that has positioned me to always be in the place of grace and be in the partaker of His grace, that the unction that He has. I try as much as possible to sow into Daddy's life as possible. And when I do that, it has always been an increase. I will encourage you to do that. Irrespective of how big or small, it is always important that you sow into His life. There is a lot that He has gotten. One of the key things that you can do to assess that is to sow into Daddy's life. Have that prophetic blessing that He owes. And I believe that we will position ourselves in a better place to be able to be partakers of the grace that He carries. There's a great unction, there's a great grace, there's the many-sided grace, and it's here in KHM. You are the right place, and I believe you. This year, the team is, we are doing well, and I tell you, I'm positioning myself properly in order to do well. Pastor Carries to you.
Amen. Come on, let's give it up unto our God. We have overcome. Let's celebrate Jesus.
Yeah.
Bible says we overcame by the word of our testimony. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. It's all about our God. Celebrate Him. Let's give Him some few seconds of thanksgiving. Lift your voice and thank the Lord. Say, Father, I thank You for this victory. We have our testimony. Lift your voice and thank Him. Come on and say, thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Jesus. Father, we are grateful. We have our testimony. We have our testimony. Kanabo shekanabaya ha. Ibaro shikanabo shaha. Ragadadadabo shaha. Ayabadu koshekaya. Come on and praise the name of the Lord. Hey, Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. We bless your name. We give you all the glory. We thank you for the restoration of our testimonies in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And we will continue to sing about the goodness of the Lord. Amen. He's a wonderful God. Hallelujah. He's a merciful God. Hallelujah. And we will continue to celebrate him. Hallelujah. And we will continue to celebrate him. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. Hey, of course, it's about him this morning. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. Oh, clap your hands, all ye people. Oh, clap your hands, all ye people. Oh, clap your hands, all ye people. Regadesha. And shout out to our God. Shout out to our God. Oh, Lord, we will continue to sing about your goodness. He's a faithful God. He's a faithful God. And we will never stop thanking you. Father, we thank you. We give you all the glory. Maya Sultana Mashaya. Thank you, Jesus. Wonderful, merciful Savior. Precious Redeemer and friend, who would have thought that a lamb could rescue the souls of man? Oh, you rescue the souls of wonderful, merciful, wonderful, merciful Savior.
your heart, come before him joyfully. Lift up your hands, begin to magnify him for the grace he's given unto you. We aren't better than those who are dead. He has made his grace final. Grace located you. Grace located me. And we are here because he allowed us. Come before him. Honor him. Friends, loved ones, every time we meet with God, there is a blessing in the space, in the sphere, in the atmosphere. Come on now, connect. Tell the Lord, I have not come to you. I have not come to man. I've come to you. For you are the blesser. You are the changer. You are the deliverer. Lebre bebeberebatos. Mrando sabrebo. In the name of Jesus, who is like unto thee among the lords, among the gods. In the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, bless us as we gather at your feet in this first service. Glorify yourself beyond measure. Let your word that transcends all continents, barriers, through the very dialect that you speak, my God, reach out to respective hearts. For you sent forth your word to heal. Let there be physical healing, financial healing, family healing, continental healing, healing for our nation, our environment, healing for our businesses, healing in all arenas of our life. For your name is Jehovah Rapha. It is your attribute to heal. It is your nature to deliver. It is your nature to set us free. Push us beyond the boundaries of religion and cause us to delve deeper into a relational prowess wherein your bliss shall be our portion. Break every bondage, deliver every captive. Lord, let, O God, the flow and the rains of joy saturate every heart under the sound of my voice. Thank you that your angels are ascending and descending. Come on, clap your hands. Thank you, Lord. Clap your hands. Thank you. Your angels are descending and ascending in this place. For in your presence, there is fullness of joy. In your presence, our transformation can be found. In your presence, your power can be seen. In your presence, there is fullness of joy. In your presence, hearts are always wonderful. Wake up, you are the one we adore. You are the one we elevate. You are the one we enthrone. You are the one we adore. You are the one we worship. You are the one. You are the one. You are the one. You are the one. Oh, my Babaya, be glorified. Oh, oh, yeah. Yeah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. In the local, as we would sing something like this. Se bebi wa si de tra. If there is something beyond thanksgiving, you are the one that I will give to. Se bebi. If there is something beyond thanksgiving, because I can't thank you enough. I can't thank you enough. Can accept. The body of Christ. This is our new year. If there is some, listen. If there is something beyond thanksgiving, I don't know whether I have a witness here in the house where somebody has done something for you, but you realize that just even giving the person a gift is not enough. Just opening your eye to say thank is not enough. Falling prostrate before the person is not enough. Cutting your head for the person is not enough. Removing your hat and putting it on a plate to offer to the person is not enough. We can't thank you enough. We can't thank you enough. Pastor watching, prophet, Bishop Wharton, wherever you find yourself, we can't thank God enough. As we move through this Holy Week, it is an insignia of another year. Don't wait for December, because that is when the church was born. That is when the debt we could not pay was paid for. No matter where you are, you can be a South African watching Chinese. Just learn this local song. Sebibri. If there is something, I want words to thank you, but I can't thank you enough for yourself, for your health, the medication, what happened last night. If there is something beyond Thanksgiving, say, come on, oh, I worship. I could instantaneously. You cross the same street. You cross the same street. Yeah, you didn't know you would have died in the journey. But when you came and you said, let them go and check the balancing of the car, the mechanics tell you this, that there would have been an accident. Look at your car tire. Look at what had happened. And you were driving 120 kilometers per hour. Whatever. But you are alive. You think this is nothing? You crossed the same street. You had an accident with somebody. The person is paralyzed. People are dying. Sudden death. Different happenings. They have better degrees and pedigree than you. Listen, listen. People who are stronger than you are dying. People who have greater degrees and pedigrees are falling. People who have more money that could buy all doctors. Hallelujah. Was it Alexander the Great or one of them who asked them that the best doctors would carry his coffin to the cemetery? Why? Because when that happens, no doctor can save you except the great physician. Great faces
shall now see the sympathizing
Jesus. He speaks the truth. He speaks the truth.
To cheer.
Oh, hear the voice of Jesus.
Hear the voice of Jesus.
There is no name above all names. There is no name
sweeter on God.
Sweetest God ever sung. Be seated. I'm forever grateful. Maybe today, this morning is your birthday. Maybe this morning is your birthday. Or you might go, it could have been your death day. They would have been celebrating your 1 week, but somehow. It's your belly, put it in the comment section. Let my God. Let my God. Listen. Come on now. One thing that we will do here and we will do in heaven is worship, adoration, and thanksgiving. Preaching will end here. Deliverance will end here. All sins will end here. Offerings will end here. Tithes will end here. But there is something that we can't stop doing. When we get there, We will even sing songs that angels, because he made us with eternity in view. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, come on now. Lift up your hands in your own dialect, whether you speak German, Spanish, whichever language, lift your voice and come on, tell Minda Boshi Abena Mau Habrosi Bretata Yadawasia Fata. Yeah, you are your Fata. Gracias. Danke. Merci, Seigneur. Come on, wherever. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Love the Lord. Love the King. He's all. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name. Let's be seated in the presence of the Lord for service. Hallelujah. I'm overflowing with thanks. Yes, we thank God every day, but you realize that you get into an era and you have to define the day in order for you to flow in its full content. And so shall we get into scripture this morning as we read from Psalm number 118. Psalm 118 from verse number 24 to the 27th verse. Friends, loved ones, live streaming, you've been live streaming with us, you know, keying into the altar and God's power in this place. We do not take it for granted. We salute you and appreciate your faith in tandem with our faith, always making it possible for us to come before God with volumes of faith. Come on, church, let's put our hands together for our e-church, our e-family, KHM diaspora, our branches all over, and people in other ministries who even worship with us before going to church. Hallelujah. Amen. We're praying for you. We know that very soon great testimonies will come in-house here. Hallelujah. We heard of the testimony of our branch pastor in Kumasi, Pastor Harry Mingle. Hallelujah. How many were here and you realize that the Lord did something marvelous? Put your hands together again and tell your neighbor your testimony is next. Oh, okay, the person is behaving some way. Say, mine is coming. You will hear. Hallelujah. People come from different walks of life to come to church. So some of them, it takes a while for them to warm up. Some of them, it takes a while. By the time their while is ended, we have shared the grace. And so when you say to them that, hey, your testimony is coming, them, because they are still on the stove. Work on quenching. Better be heard. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, your testimony is coming. And then hallelujah. Yes, KHM, that's what friends love. What you can send yours as well. And we will make the needful. We'll do the needful for you. Hallelujah. Is somebody in the house? Amen. Are we ready to take off? Psalm number 118. Psalm 118. And verse number 24. I read it says that this is the day which the Lord had made. No president made it. It was not made from the Eastern nation. It was not made by any pastor, apostle, prophet, doctor, poho, or somebody. But this is the day the Lord has made. So if you have any blessing and gratitude, give it to God. Oh, the glory must be. Come on, for he is worthy of hallelujah. this is the day which the Lord had made. Somebody is crying out there watching because they said you wouldn't be alive, but you have crossed a satanic bridge into the place of life. They kept you in the tomb thinking that you would not come out, but this morning you are still breathing. Something happened last night. You thought that, my God, but the Lord came through for you. They put you in a lion's den thinking that you will become a supper, a dinner for some lions, but by the time you realize they were calling your name and you were coming, because the great intervener. This is the day which the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Verse number 25. He says that save now. If it is the day, then we have worked for the day because we have defined the day. Tell three people, define the day, define the day. Your redefinition in life is contingent on your definition of the day that God. Did you hear me? You can write it by your best. Your redefinition of your life, because life is evolving. We are getting better and better and better. I say I am a work in progress. So when you have defined the day, it's the Lord's day. We come into the place, then having known the content of the day, its quantum and what God is capable of doing. The scripture says that he daily loads us with benefits. If it is that God, then there are benefits in the day. Then I will key in. I will tap into it. I will sow into it. I will love into it. I will prophesy into it. I will say my I ams in it. I will say my I am not in it. I will make a decree in it. In the name of Jesus, I give you some few seconds. Make a decree in the day before I continue. Come on now, you can do better. Come on, you can do better. You can do better. You can do better. You can do better. By the time I finish this, the scripture, you should be good. You should be good. Sometimes some entrees and then starters in a meal, they are so good that even before you get to the meal, Charlie, you are already there. Amen. So then when they saw, he said, save now. Somebody shall save now. Somebody shall save now. Somebody say save now. So now, save now was accosted to somebody greater than them. Was said to somebody greater. I beseech thee, O Lord. And so that person who received those words was the Lord. O Lord, I beseech thee, send now prosperity. I might not come into these corridors. Write it down. Prosperity is needful for your next level. Prosperity there goes beyond consumerism and materialism. Prosperity there is chalak. Move me forward. How many want to get forward in health? You want to get forward in joy, in love, in marriage? Oh, come on, you can't sit and move forward. Come on, demonstrate it prophetically. Say, I'm moving forward. I'm a walking, talking miracle. I'm moving to my next dimension of thriving. Oh, your zeros in addition to your figures are going to increase. Oh my God, move from the four zeros to the five, to the six, to the seven, to the eight. I am moving forward. It says that I beseech thee, send now. Not tomorrow, because faith is now. Send now. Say, Lord, send now. Now, the word there is chalak. It means push me forward. One day at a time, push me forward. Oh, yes. Oh, another touch, push me forward. Not only that, the lepers got up and said, when we stay here, we die. When we move backwards, we die. But they started moving, and the Lord amplified their steps, your steps prophetically. Before I finish reading the scripture, will be amplified, because when friends and loved ones couldn't be found, the fourth man intervened. Labro seka tonaya. Send now. Send now. Not tomorrow. Send now. Who needs it? Send now. Oh, send now. Send now. Verse number 20 says, I wish this was a swimming pool and I would lay in this scripture. That is more than a swimming pool. By the washing of the water of the word. Then it goes, verse number 20 says, blessed be he that cometh in the name of the Lord. We have blessed you out of the house of the Lord. Somebody shout hallelujah. Now verse 27 brings a transition that is needful for your transformation. Brings up an information for your transformation. And then it says, God is the Lord. And as we bring our offerings, we usually say it here. Which has showed us the light. Jesus, the light of the world. Now, if the Jews of the sentence consider, bind the sacrifice with cord, even unto the horn of the altar. I've made us to understand the greatest altar ever is the cross. Let me start from that point. Hallelujah. Amen. The altar of the cross has power. There is power in the cross. Hello? And the sacrifice is Jesus Christ, our Passover lamb, who was nailed to the cross. Are we here? Now, can we go on, man? Hallelujah. I'm joining myself. Hallelujah. So in Matthew 21:9, for time's sake, Matthew 21:9, the Bible says, Matthew 21:9, it says that, and the multitude that went before and that followed, that went before and that followed, so he was sandwiched by multitude, cried saying, Hosanna. Everybody say Hosanna. Everybody say Hosanna. That is save now. Hosanna. Hosanna. Save now, just as we read in Psalm 118. It says, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he. This is what we read in that verse 20. It says, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. And they didn't rest. They said, Hosanna. Hosanna is save. And now is now. In the highest, not in the lowest. Hallelujah. Shout, accept the Most High, and so his highest and best shall be my portion. In a short while, I just want to share with us Hosanna for our utmost intervention and visitation. Hosanna. Hosanna for my utmost intervention. As we press into the fourth month, the month of April, the fourth man wants to step into the corridors of your life, the equation of your life. Hallelujah. Like the three Hebrew boys put in the fire, the fourth man was seen. He says that his countenance was like the Son of Man who came in and saved them. As you push into the fourth month, may the fourth man with divine intervention and visitation step into your equation of your life in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Very, very interesting. In our day and age today, we usually call it the Palm Sunday. And growing up, our parents will prepare palm nut soup. And when you are a child, you know the palm nut soup is different. Then you know that, you know, today is Palm Sunday. Hallelujah. Get ready to get soil your shirt with some palm oil and other things and so on and so forth. Hallelujah. If you were in my days where we had the Abbey Wood and then the palm canal mortar, and then you are called to palm it and pound and pound and pound and pound. Do you still have yours in your house? You don't use Nkulemu or whichever. All right. Nkumemu. All right, so then it got into some practices and rituals. We go into church and then we sing, especially in the Sunday school. Yeah, Hosanna. Yeah, Hosanna. Yeah, Hosanna. Then we all put in our words. Hak, hak, hak. We didn't know hak, hak. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Then anybody bode. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Right, I be there. Hooray! Oh, you are behaving as if you didn't do it. And so we would do it, we would get the palm fronds and we will weave the menkons. Do you know menkons? The leaves of the palm. And so you weave it and then we begin to fight on it. Some of us will love fight. Fight on it because I did some nice creative thing and you took it from me. And so we'll be fighting. And the neighborhood confusion. Our parents too are fighting in the compound because of men council. And we weave it around our necks and our hands. Who made the watch with the wristwatch? Come on, talk. Come on, lift up your hand. Let me see you. All the computer 8 people did. You are just surfing on TikTok. Hallelujah. Amen. And so those things characterize, you know, the Palm Sunday and so on. And then many people who usually don't go to church begin to go to church. And those whose dress have been delayed with the tailor, we go to Uncle Taylor. I remember my Uncle Taylor was from... Uncle Taylor, he would say that, oh, I have cut it, but I couldn't finish. Then my mother would go, why? Because today is Palm Sunday. Even though they don't go to church, they want all of us to go to church. And my father would say he attends a particular church he has never been before. My mother too would say he also attends a particular church he has never been before. And we are confused. So we will go between those churches and then we will use our offering for granite. Ah, who also bought some? You are behaving as if you are angels. The blood that makes the difference. Hallelujah. But beyond all those, you know, what you call religious, you know, accents and practices and rituals that surrounds it. And when we get into the church and the activity and the whole church will be full and so on and so forth. You know, beyond that is a proper intent and meaning for Hosanna. Hallelujah. There is a proper relevance and revelation for Hosanna, because you are a revelation away from revenues you have never received in life before. You are a revelation away from a blissful marriage you are expecting for. You are a revelation away from a revamped health. You are a revelation away from hitting a jackpot of a new work. You are a revelation away. And so Ephesians says this in Ephesians 1:18, that their eyes of understanding may be open. Verse number 17 of same says this, that the Lord will grant you the spirit of revelation and wisdom. And we thank God for his goodness that he's giving us a revelation in this. Hallelujah. Amen. And the whole deal was this, that in the scriptures that we have read, the psalmist, you know, manifests and speaks forth what was to come in terms of the Messiah and how he will come and save his people and how the whole procedure will go. And so he comes and says that this is the day the Lord has made, that we should rejoice and be glad in it. Say, I am the one. Say, I am the one. And then now he goes to the verse number 25 and he says categorically here, he says that now that I know the day, he says that now, save now, oh Lord, save now, send now prosperity. And so save now in the Hebraic essence, the original language, hallelujah, is Hosanna, as in Hosanna. So the psalmist started talking about Hosanna before the people did hear Hosanna. And in those days, you know, specifically during the feast of the Passover, you know, Jesus Christ had to ask the disciples to go ahead of him into a village and then see if they will find a donkey tied, hallelujah, with its cords. In Matthew 21, all these are there. And the Bible makes us to understand that Jesus Christ's disciples went and he gave them the clue. He says that the caveat is that if somebody asks you, why are you taking this? Say, the Lord. Everybody say, the Lord. The Lord is in need of this. And they will not say anything. They will not fight you. So they went. They brought the donkey. They brought the cord. And then he had to sit on it. Before he sat on it, we all read, and it's a normal story in our Sunday school, they put cloth on it to create a makeshift seat on it, because those donkeys, and when you are seated, there should be some kind of leathery whatsoever seat, but so they put it on it, make it a bit softer, and then also palm fronds and then clothes and other things, they laid it down for the donkey to go through. Hallelujah. Now Jesus Christ had to do all this in fulfillment of another prophecy in Zechariah chapter number 9 and verse number 9. Zechariah chapter number 9 and verse number 9. Rejoice greatly, O daughters of Zion, invariably the church. Hallelujah. O daughters of Jerusalem, behold, thy king cometh unto thee. He is just and having salvation. He is just. He is righteous. And having salvation, he's having your deliverance, he's having your aid, he's having your victory, he's having your prosperity, he's having your welfare, he's having your good health. Shout, I am the one. Lowly and riding upon the an ass and upon the cord and the fowl of an ass. And so this is what Jesus also says in Matthew 11, 28, thereabouts. Come unto me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. My burden is light, my yoke is easy. I will not treat you like your oppressors treat you. So now, this were all to fulfill the prophetic word of the Lord. But in its relevance, we should get to that place of understanding that Jesus Christ was sent for us men, for our salvation, to intervene because of the gap that was between us and God. Hallelujah. Sin is a separator. Sin is a separator. And so because of sin separation, we see over here that Jesus Christ had to come. And so therefore, telling these words, we come into that realization that the people of Jerusalem, the people of God, the people of Zion, the high priests, the Pharisees, the Sadducees of the day did not understand his coming. And anything you don't understand, most of the time we fight. Anything we don't understand, we most of the time, you know, oppose. Hallelujah. And sometimes by the time you understand, the blessing is gone. And many a time when we don't understand, psychologically it is a lack of information. And the other divide of it is this, that it might not just merely be a lack of information, but a misinformation making you believe in the wrong. that the Messiah will come as a kind of Samson who will come and set us free from the oppressor's rule, because in those days the Roman Empire had, you know, captivated the Jewish people and had ruled them. They were their oppressors. And anytime there is oppression, there is depression. Anytime there is depression, there is suppression. There is, hallelujah, repression. There is subjugation. Hallelujah. People are not able to be free. There is no freedom. And so the people there, based on the information around and the politicking around, even though Jesus has come, he came to his own, but his own received him not. Why? Because they didn't have the information, or they were misinformed. And anytime you are misinformed or you don't have an information, you can't expect. So that even if the expectation of the miracle is a new job, is a probable husband, a probable wife, the person will stand before you, but you will judge the book by the cover and miss the miracle. I'm interjecting. Tell your neighbor, don't miss your miracle. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so then the truth of the people saying Hosanna, you can go back to, you know, Psalm 118 verse number 25. The reason for the people shouting Hosanna was an utmost praise and worship unto God, number one. Number two, that we are tired of the oppression. We are tired of the suppression. We are tired of the affliction. We are tired of the repression. We are full of it. And I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. And these issues must stop. These afflictions in our neighborhood must stop. And so when they had been there and they saw that Jesus was fulfilling Zechariah chapter 9 verse number 9, they were misinformed. They thought that because of the past, how Samson did it, the Messiah will come and give them physical deliverance. But Jesus came and was giving them spiritual deliverance. Because when you get it first in the spirit, you can get it physically. Tell four people, get it first in the spirit, and you get it physically. Get it first in the spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So they were expecting a Samson kind of guy. Come on, come and beat this Roman Empire for us. Set us free. In the same way in our life, before we rise up to pray, many of us are going through oppression. If you are not being oppressed by somebody, you are suppressing, repressing yourself. Somebody else, the neighborhood, the politicking in Africa, all the happening in the environment. Yesterday, one of our sisters was asking, so Pastor, how are you able to live in this very city? And then you look at things, things are still the same on our road. Paint on walls are still the same. And you see it and you, I said, I'm not okay with it. But I am just being obedient to the law in terms of his calling and where he has assigned me to be, because he's a God of a place. And tomorrow by this time, the tide could change. Because when you look at everything, the work that you are doing, our currency, city, has no value. Hallelujah. Adding insult to injury, the confusion in our parliament, the confusion in the presidency, the executive, the legislature, and so on. The cacophony of things on our mass media and social media and so on. All the confusion. How many feel it in your pocket? How many feel it as with the type of a tap off and the doom so? How many feel it? Hallelujah. It is affecting marriages. It is affecting people's academic life. It is affecting the people's thinking. It is affecting mental health. The people were subjugated in the day. Hallelujah. Amen. Why? Because you see, when you are repressed, oppressed to some point, if you don't take care, if you were in a previous marriage and you get into another marriage or something, if you don't take care, you'll be apprehensive in the new marriage the rest of your life. Hallelujah. And when you get to the, you get into a zone of desperation, and a desperate person will take anything for an answer. Anything bitter is sweet to a hungry man. You got there and they said, what do you have at the kitchen? I'm hungry, I'm hungry. Usually, when you were not over hungry, you would take your time, cook the food and serve yourself. Clap for you. But you see that you are a lady, but you have not, you put one leg there and they'll be eating from the stove. Hallelujah. And so the people's situation made them desperate, and they were looking for desperate answers and what we call unmanaged expectation. Hello? I said unmanaged expectation. So now they can do same brataya. Let me, for time's sake, I can't say, oh, we'll continue in the second service. But the truth is that when you get into marriage with an unmanaged expectation, you will be surprised. Many marriages are falling. A managed parenting expectation, you'll be surprised. You won't be content. There will be trauma. There will be confusion. Hallelujah. Because oppression brings trauma. And when you get into that, you realize that if it's a new work, you have gotten into the work, you went in humbly. But when you started seeing the money flowing, now your expectation is big that they should increase my salary now. If your expectation is not managed well, you can leave the work before your true blessing comes. So the sense in the relevance of this was this, that they had expectation that we want to be free. How many have been in a place and you are still there, you want to be free? The Bible says you shall know the truth and the truth shall make you free. He came to make us free. Hallelujah. Jesus came to set us free. And so with all their unmanaged expectation, they began accosting Jesus. Hosanna, save now. Not tomorrow. How many want a now miracle? You want a now miracle as a pastor. You want a now miracle as a singer. You want a now miracle as somebody believing God for the fruit of the womb. You want a now miracle for your healing. There is only one person who is Lord of Lords, King of Kings, who can save us. And his name is Jesus. The Bible says in Acts chapter 4 verse number 12, there is no name that one can be saved except in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Somebody say Jesus. Shout Jesus. Say Hosanna. Say save now. Save now. Where I need his Hosanna might be different from where you need his Hosanna, but collectively shall we shout Hosanna. So we are not singing just religiously, but we are accosting God who loves to be called. Say, my God loves to be called. He said, call on me and I will show you great and mighty things. Things that you have never seen before. Hallelujah. Shout Hosanna. A miracle is coming to somebody here. I said a miracle is coming to somebody. Favor is locating somebody. Hallelujah. Because now you understand that the Messiah came to set us free. Shout Hosanna. Say save now. Say save now. Send now prosperity. Oh, say save now. Send now prosperity. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That is the relevance of Hosanna in our day, that we will call on him. The Bible says in Romans chapter 10 and verse number 13. Hallelujah. It says that whoever calls on the name, for whosoever, whether you are, you know, a Dagari, and Zema, a German, an European, an American, Caucasian, whatsoever you are, ever, he said, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Some trust in chariots, others in horses, but we will say our Hosanna. I will shout my Hosanna. My child comes from school and has an issue with her academic life. I pray and I declare Hosanna. I go to work and there is some kind of confusion at work. We must solve the problem. Hosanna. I go into my marriage. My husband is not understanding our communication. My wife is not understanding. I need a Hosanna. Oh my God, the finances is so short. The bed is so short to stretch on. The cover cloth so narrow. Oh my God, I was with a child, but when I brought forth wind. I need Hosanna. Hosanna in Ghana. Hosanna in Africa. Hosanna in our schools. Hosanna in our businesses. Hosanna in the church. Hosanna in the highest. So then the deal becomes this. Hosanna must not be to the lowest. Hosanna must be to the highest. I will lift up my eyes to the hills. Whence cometh my help? My help comes from Hosanna in the highest. Cursed be any man who puts his trust in man. So the same people, group of people, first group of people were Galileans who followed Jesus Christ, and they had been in his ministry, and many were expecting their miracle. That was why they were part of the multitude. The second group of people were the Jewish people. They were suspicious of his ministry, and the high priest had joined them, and they wanted an occasion to kill him. Hallelujah. The third group of people were the people who were visitors who had come for the Passover feast, and they didn't know what was happening, so they were just looking. And so by the time the Palm Sunday, they had said Hosanna, and the people were calling and accosting the Lord for an intervention. By the Friday, the Jewish people had convinced the people that stop saying Hosanna, he can't give you salvation, let us kill him. So they said crucify. Rise up on your feet, man. Rise up on your feet. Rise up on your feet wherever you are. The devil is a liar. My Hosanna now. Hosanna now. Save now. Hallelujah. He said we should call on him and he will hear, he will answer. Hallelujah. The psalmist says several times, I called on the Lord with my voice and he heard me from his holy hill. Hallelujah. Our eyes are on you, because when you look up to man, when man gives you bread, 2 days they will be tired, they will be bored of you. When they pay your children's school fees, they will be tired of you, but God will never be bored of you. That is why his love is agape. He loves us plus our mistake. He is the one we must accost. He is the one we must call. Lift up your hand if you have a Hosanna issue. Hallelujah. This is the day the Lord has made. Lift your voice. I don't know what you are carrying. I don't know which burden you are having, but there is a God who, when we say Hosanna to, when we say Hosanna to, when we shout Hosanna to, he will show up beyond religion into a place of relationship. What the doctors and the medication cannot heal, Hosanna, save now. Give me my deliverance. Give me my aid. Give me my victory. Give me my good health. Give me my prosperity. Give me my welfare. Hosanna. Oh my God. Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. This morning we come. I come. Shout, I come in the name of the Lord. 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 Come to God right now. Come to God right now. There are people who want to redirect your Hosanna. Rabobo Zabraya. Zebreya Papa. Sekabarabaya Yabrabatora Yabrasaya Salibaloborobaya Rabababosaya Yabrapopoya Rapopoya Adrekaya. Lift your voice. Come before the King of Kings. Come before the Lord of Lords. Come before the King of Kings. Rabababababaya Rabababababaya Rapopoya Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Can you give us back Zechariah chapter number 9 and verse number 9? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okay. All right. So, the word there is that he is just. Say, my God is just.
My God is just.
And having salvation. Say, my God is just.
My God is just.
And having salvation.
And having salvation.
And you continue, the Bible says he is low, lowly, and riding on upon an ass. Hallelujah. He's lowly, even though he's the most high. He comes in the most meekest form. Hallelujah. And the scripture stipulate in Matthew 21:9. It says that Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna must not be to the lowest. Somebody shout Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna in the highest.
So now when literally you look at people, you want to see the person riding high. Jesus. Before you call the person. Oh, this one, he will get the investment, the money that I need. Oh, this one, so that is why you call them as chairman. And then you are doing your program. You won't even pray about the program. Whom God wants you to bring there. Oh, this one. And then many of us pastors who are blind, who say, hey, go and get people who. And then we miss it. Hosanna must be to the highest. Do you know the truth on this prayer? The truth is this. There are several, counterfeit highest people who are lofty, but they are not high in holiness. They are proud. They are pompous. They are showing a form of godliness. They are glittering gold, but all that glitters is not gold. And they are enticing many people to accost their save now too. So they want, tell your neighbor, the devil wants your Hosanna. Tell another person, the devil wants your Hosanna. So whoever saves you becomes your deliverer, becomes your Lord. Who is your Lord? My Hosanna must be to the highest, not the lowest. My Hosanna. Some of you have put your trust in men. Some of you have put your trust in the promise of people. Listen, the unmanaged expectations of the people of the day made them be convinced by the high priest to crucify Christ. I pray in this season that as we come, God will transform you. Lift up your hand. Say, I retract my Hosanna from the wrong people.
I take it
from the wrong source.
The wrong source.
And I give it all, to Jesus.
To Jesus.
To the Most High.
To the Most High.
Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna in the highest.
Hosanna in the highest. Lift your voice and pray. Hallelujah. When you put your trust in man, you are conquered. Come on, come before the Lord. Friends, loved ones, this is the day the Lord has made. Save now my marriage. Save now my ministry. Save now my monetary life. Save now the business plan. Save now the community. Save now Africa. Save now our politicians. Save now our leaders. Save now our parliamentary members. Save now widows. People have been bereaved all over. Hallelujah. Save now. Save now the body of Christ. Save now. Save now. By your power. Save now. Save now. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. But the lowest, our children. Oh God, save now. Save now. Our teachers, our lecturers, our lawyers, our professors. Save now our women, our men. Save now the body of Christ in the name of Jesus. Save now. Rabo Zebede. Save now.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. If your Hosanna doesn't go to the highest, you may sell your soul to the Lord. Because the devil will never give you anything without a time bomb. Hallelujah. They position themselves in a way, there could be people in your circle of influence, they position themselves in a way that you will even find it difficult looking beyond them to God. But our Hosanna must be to the highest. If our Hosanna is going to the highest, you might be here, you realize that, Pastor, I have the revelation. All these years, I have the revelation. If I have the revelation, then I want to redevote my life to you. I want you to come into my life. Be my Lord, my personal Savior. Why? Because life is short. Death is sure. Sin is the cause. Christ, our Messiah, the one who must receive our Hosanna in the highest, is the cure. Say this word after me, Lord Jesus. I come before you and I resign from giving my Hosanna to the wrong. I retract my trust, my dependency on man, on chariot, and I give it back to you. Come into my heart. Wash me with your blood. Be my Lord, my personal Savior. Let me always direct my Hosanna to you in my lifetime. In Jesus' name. If you have received the first service, put your hands together to the glory of God and take your offering. Just want us to understand, as you are taking your offering, that this day also equals the launch of our next convocation. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Divine visitation and intervention. And I've just preached to us, Hosanna, for my intervention and visitation. So throughout the week, we are praying and coming before the Lord in fasting and prayer. What a week, a holy week. Hallelujah. We're coming before the Lord, loving God. Hallelujah. Amen. Going into the story and the revelation. Hallelujah. Behind the story. So tomorrow we are meeting here 5:30. Hallelujah. Amen. Seeking the face of the Lord. Tuesday we are gathering here 5:30. Wednesday we'll get deeper. Hallelujah. And then Thursday there's going to be a special anointing service. We'll get deeper into what Christ, the one who receives our Hosanna, received for us. We'll have a special anointing service. Hallelujah. Amen. In the evening, in the morning, there will be hour of prayer from 9 a.m. in the evening, 5:30. Friday is Good Friday. Somebody say, yeah, yeah. Somebody shout, yeah, yeah. Type it in the comment section. Yeah, yeah. Put it there. Hallelujah. Yeah, yeah. Royals, come behind me. Hallelujah. We are believing God. We are believing God. It is going to be one service. It starts from service, 7 a.m. It's not going to be a rush service. Come, it's going to be a deliverance and a prophetic time. Bring everyone in your house. Invite your landlord. Invite invite your boss, everyone. Hallelujah. Somebody shout, I'm coming. Somebody shout, I'm coming. Tell your neighbor, save the date. Hallelujah. So there will be a special anointing service in the morning. Usually we have, you know, a special Igero anointing service on the Saturday, Easter Saturday. But because God has blessed us to have a convocation within the Holy Week, we'll have it on Friday. And Saturday morning, early morning, encounter segment will come through. And then on Sunday, one service, resurrection morning, Igero morning. Hallelujah. Come, let's push past religion. Pastor, friends, prophets who have been watching, come, let's push past. Hallelujah. Really, it's going to be awesome. Amen. Tell your neighbor, I'm going to be there. I will be there. Hallelujah. Lift up your offering, your tithes. If you have your tithes in the house, you are doing it via Momo. You know, just do it via our details on the screen. Hallelujah. We lift it. You have some special first fruit. You have your project offering. Father, we lift it before you. Let your blessings, let your power, let your goodness be on our offering. Bless us beyond this geographical location. Touch all the continents, oh God, that have keyed in, oh God, into your presence in this first service. In Jesus' mighty name, we declare God's goodness over you all out there against all odds. In Jesus' mighty name, may the Lord rebuke the devourer for your sake. Through Christ Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Come rejoice, and shall we rise up, and then with your mem consuno and with your palm branch. Some people have started making cross out of it. I see, sister, your weave is powerful. Come on, let's come with all the dust. Come on. Significance, it stands for victory. It is victory. Hallelujah. Amen. In those days, the victors, the soldiers who came out from war, and they came out at a procession around cheering them, they took palm fronds. Hallelujah. Amen. And during the Feast of Tabernacle as well, they went around with the palm front. Hallelujah. Say, my victory is here. Say, my deliverance is here. Say, my prosperity is here. My welfare is here. My good health is here. My aid is here. I declare it now as I wave my palm front in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Somebody shout, Hosanna.
Hosanna.
In the highest. In the highest. Hosanna. In the highest. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this service. We thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your power. We thank you for your visitation over our lives. So God, we go through the Holy Week and the Holy Convocation, believing you for your visitation throughout the week's long program. Visit us beyond measure. Change our status. Relieve us from oppression, suppression, repression, depression, affliction, and all forms of deceit. In the name of Jesus. You ask us that is any afflicted, let him pray. We have come before you, accosting your name, calling on your name, that you will show yourself strong. Let this be a victorious week. Let it be a victorious week as we wave our palm fronds. Let it be a victorious week in the name of Jesus. By this prophetic token, let it be a victorious week. We honor you that you have stepped in as a fourth man and you have blessed us beyond measure. In Jesus' name, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Pascal is to us all. See you in the second service.